This is a tube bank problem where we have condensing steam at 100 degrees C, which is used in the inside of a tube of banks to heat air that enters at one atmosphere, 25 degrees C, with a velocity of 5 meters per second. Tubes are 1 meter long. The diameter is 10 millimeters. There are 196 tubes in a square aligned array, S sub T, which is the pitch, equals S sub L, which is 15 millimeters, and we want the total heat transfer rate to the air. So let's start with our governing equation. So we're looking for Q, and Q is our heat transfer coefficient times the number of tubes in the tube bank times the surface area of one of the tubes times our delta T log mean. And the reason we use a log mean temperature rather than just a delta T is because there can be such a difference from the inlet to the outlet. So delta T log mean is Ts minus Ti, where 100 degrees is the temperature of the surface, Ti is the 25 degrees C, minus Ts minus To, divided by the natural log of Ts minus Ti divided by Ts minus To. And we have Ts and Ti, but what we don't have is To. So we can find To from this expression, Ts minus T out divided by Ts minus T in equals the exponential of minus pi d n h bar divided by rho times the velocity times the number of tubes in the transverse direction times the pitch in the transfer direction times our heat capacity. So since it's 196 tubes and it's square, our number of tubes in the transverse direction is 14. So we have everything here, or we can look up the properties, except for our h-bar, our heat transfer coefficient. And actually, we're going to need it when we solve for Q. So let's go ahead and find it. So our plan is to find our h-bar. From that, we can find our t-outlet. From that, we can find our delta t-log mean. And finally, we can solve for our Q. So our h-bar is a Nusselt number times the K of the fluid divided by the diameter. So we have to look up the proper correlation for our Nusselt number, and here we use the Zukauskas correlation that says that the Nusselt number, again this is the average one, is some constant that's a correction for anything that has less than 20 tubes in the longitudinal direction, which we do, we have 14. Then a constant that's based on the Reynolds number, then Reynolds raised to the m, where this m is also based on the Reynolds number, Prandtl to the 0.36, and then Prandtl divided by Prandtl at the surface to the 1/4. So let's calculate our Reynolds number. And our Reynolds number is based on our V max times D divided by our kinematic viscosity. And our maximum velocity is the pitch in the transverse direction divided by the pitch in the transverse direction minus the diameter times our velocity. So our maximum velocity is 15 meters per second. So we can put this in our Reynolds number. So we have 15 meters per second times the diameter, which is 0.01 meter, divided by 15.89 times 10 to the minus 6 meters squared per second. So our Reynolds number is 9,494. Then we go to the appropriate table, which gives us first our C and our M based on the Reynolds number. So our C is going to be 0.27. Our M is going to be 0.63. And our C2, again, because we're less than 20 tubes in the longitudinal direction, is approximately 0.99. So not a big correction factor. So now let's calculate our Nusselt number. 0.99 times 0.27 times 94, our Reynolds number, raised to the 0.63. Our Prandtl number, raised to the 0.36. And then our Prandtl number divided by the Prandtl number at the surface, or 100 degrees C, raised to the 1/4. And our Nusselt number equals 75.9. From that, we can get our H-bar, which is 75.9 times 0.0263 watts per meter, that's the K of the fluid, divided by the diameter, 0.01 meters. So our H is 200 watts per meter squared K. So now we go back to delta T log mean and solve for, actually we're going to solve for TS minus T out, because we're going to newt that. So our TS minus T out, again, let's go back up here and show that it's going to equal TS minus TI times the exponential of minus, and now let's put in some of these. We pi, D is 0.01, N is the number of tubes, which is 196. H-bar, we just found out, 200 watts per meter squared K. And we divide this by the density, which is 1.17 kilograms per meter squared cubed, times the velocity, not Vmax, which is 5 meters per second, times the number of tubes in the transverse direction, which is 14, times the pitch in the transverse direction, which is 0.015, times our heat capacity, which is 1,007. And when we calculate that difference, we find that TS minus TO is 27.7 degrees C. And I left off the units for our heat capacity. That's 1,007 joules per kilogram K. So TS minus TO equals 27.7 degrees C. Our TS minus TI equals 75 degrees C. Now we can find our Q, which is our H bar, 200 watts per meter squared K, times the number of tubes, which is 196, times pi, times the diameter, times the length of the tube, and this is going to be times our delta log mean temperature, which is 75, that's the TS minus TI, minus 27.7 degrees C, that's our TS minus TO, divided by the log of 75 divided by 27.7. And when we calculate that out, we find that Q is 58.5 kilowatts.